Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel BioExplorer. I'm Dibunjaya Ratna. This is an educational channel and this channel will be very useful to improve your biological knowledge. Today in this video we are going to talk about the outermost part of plant cells, that is the cell wall. Cell wall is an extracellular structural layer that surrounds some types of cells. It is found in most prokaryotes, algae, fungi, and in eukaryotes such as plants. However, prokaryotes, fungi, and some protists also have a thin and flexible cell wall. Plant cell wall is generally made up of cellulose, pectin, hemicellulose, lignin, and suberin. The chemical composition of the wall greatly varies from species to species and even from one cell type to another, even in same plant. In this section, we are going to discuss about plant cell walls. The walls of plant cells must have sufficient tensile strength to withstand internal osmotic pressures. Plant cell walls vary from 0.1 to several micrometers in thickness. Three layers can be found in plant cells as primary cell wall, secondary cell wall, and middle lamella. Primary cell wall is permeable, relatively thin, and flexible, which is in the outside of the cell membrane. The middle lamella is laid down first, formed from the cell plate during cytokinesis, and the primary cell wall is then deposited inside the middle lamella. Primary cell wall is mainly composed of cellulose, hemicellulose, and pectin. They are all carbohydrates. The cellulose fibers in the primary cell wall are laid unevenly running through the extracellular matrix, that is middle lamella. Those cellulose microfibrils are produced at the plasma membrane. Water can move freely through the free spaces of the cell wall. The outer part of the primary cell wall of the plant epidermis is usually impregnated with cutin and wax, forming a permeability barrier known as plant cuticle. Middle lamella. Just outside the primary cell wall, there is a thin layer called middle lamella, which is rich in pectin. They are sticky polysaccharides that consist of magnesium and calcium pectate. Middle lamella forms the interface between adjacent plant cells and glues them together. Secondary cell wall. In some types of plant cells, after a maximum size or point in development has been reached, a secondary cell wall is constructed between the plasma membrane and primary cell wall due to the deposition of hardening substances in the primary cell wall. It contains several layers of hard materials forming a rigid structure. Secondary cell wall also contain cellulose and hemicellulose as in primary cell wall, but in addition to them, impermeable substances such as lignin and suberin are also incorporated into the secondary cell wall. Lignin and suberin are complex molecules that function as permeability barriers to the movement of water. Lignin cement anchors cellulose fibers together, providing hard and rigid matrix, giving the cell wall an extra support. Cell wall has pits through which cytoplasm of adjoining cells join through plasmodesmata, which allows cell-to-cell communication. Fungi. functions of cell wall. First one, provide and support. Cell walls give cells rigidity and strength, offering protection against mechanical stress. Allows development of turgidity. Turgidity is the point at which the cell's membrane pushes against cell wall, which is when tubular pressure is high. The apparent rigidity of primary plant tissues is enabled by cell walls. Third one, prevent bursting during turgidity. The flexibility of the cell wall, meaning that it will bend rather than holding a fixed shape, help to prevent bursting the cell when water flows more and more into the cell. Fourth one, limits and control cell growth. Component of apoplast pathway. Apoplast is the space outside the plasma membrane within which materials can diffuse freely. It facilitates the transport of water and solutes across the tissue or organ. Fifth one, maintaining cell shape and hold the plant up against the force of gravity. So that's for today. Hope you enjoy this video and gain lot of interesting facts about cell wall for your biological knowledge. So please subscribe this channel and click the bell icon. See you in the next video.